everybody, and thank you so much for taking the time to tune into this. This is my second installment in the Mindfulness for Educators series that I wanted to put out in the world. And in this video, I'm just going to overview a strategy that I personally find incredibly helpful throughout the day as a teacher to put myself in the place that I feel like I'm most productive and most myself. So we're gonna start with a guided meditation. And for this, you can be seated in any comfortable position. So you might be seated in a chair, maybe on the ground, leaned up against the wall. I invite you to just set up in such a way that you're not gonna be distracted too much by the physical body. You'll be fairly comfortable. And you can let your hands rest, palms face down on your legs. And from here, if it feels comfortable to close your eyes, you can go ahead and do so. If you'd rather keep them cracked open, just direct your gaze downward. And from here, take a moment simply to observe your breath. Notice its depth, its pace, its quality. So often we use just the top third of our capacity. So notice if your breath extends all the way down to the diaphragm, or if it seems to reside mostly in the top portion of the lungs. And on an inhale, we're gonna draw the breath deeply in. So inhale all the way down to the low belly, up through the lungs, into the throat. And exhale through the mouth, draw the navel in, let it go. Let's do one more of those. Inhaling all the way down to the diaphragm, through the lungs, into the throat. Sip in a little bit more at the top, maybe even a little bit more. Exhale through the mouth. Let the breath be a little more natural, but keep the breath long and deep. Not pushing quite to the extent we just did, but allowing the breath to fully explore the body on an inhale and to fully leave the body on an exhale. Wherever you are, slide your hands slightly further back on your thighs, draw your shoulders up toward your ears, and then soften them toward each other on the back. Relax the jaw. Relax the eyelids. Notice how the stillness feels. Notice your thoughts. Remind yourself, in this moment, you are not your thoughts. They're simply something that goes on in your brain. The fact that you can observe them implies you are separate from them. Now, I invite you to picture in your mind your most ideal version of your future self. Whether it be a year from now or 10 years from now, if everything went right and well, the most ideal way for this person to have been shaped, what would that person look like? What energy does this person give off? Imagine them just moving around and notice how they move. Notice their facial expression. Picture this person doing an activity. How do they move throughout that activity? Again, what energy do they exude? And I want you to feel for a moment your connection to this person, this ideal future version of yourself. Know that this person would have grown from where you are. Know that they would feel love and compassion toward you. Note the love and compassion you feel toward them as well. Continue to bask in this person's energy for just a moment longer, noting what it's like to be in their presence. On an inhale, I want you to imagine absorbing the essence of that person. Everything that you imagine that this person feels, inhale it into yourself. And then exhale, release that back into the world. We can begin to awaken once again, maybe cracking the eyes gently open, allowing a little bit of light back in before opening the eyes fully. Now, the reason I wanted to walk you through this meditation on your future ideal self is because in any moment we have the opportunity to be that person, to show up as that person. Right? This is how we affect change in our lives, is we imagine, okay, what would that person do? And then we do that. So throughout our days as educators, we have so many decisions that we have to make, and we have so many forces at play. I think education is typically an occupation filled with a lot of just chaos and busyness and fast-paced action all the time. And so it can be easy to just let our defaults take over and to respond to any given moment in whatever way is easiest for us, right? And that easiest way is what we call our personality. It's what we've conditioned ourselves to do over the years, whether intentionally or unintentionally. And so throughout the day, if we allow ourselves a few moments at a time to remember to pause and to remember that we do get to choose how we respond, we don't have to go with that default, that allows us to move with intention throughout the day, throughout the week, the month, the year, the entirety of the career. And that's a lot. There's a lot of agency in that. It doesn't mean we're always going to remember to pause. It doesn't mean that we're always going to show up as this best version of ourselves. It doesn't mean that what we think that person would do is actually the best option. But it's experimentation. It takes a little bit of testing the waters to determine what the best thing is in any given moment. And in us pausing, we realize that we have the power to create space in any given day. You have experienced that when you have looked at your students and said, you know what, we need more time on this project. And that doesn't fit in with what I had scheduled, but I'm giving us more time, right? We've all done that. Probably just within the last week, you've done that. And so think of extending that same graciousness, that same compassion toward yourself. So throughout the day, as questions, as decisions arise, allow yourself even just a moment, a minute, not even a full minute in many instances, maybe it's just a breath that you can think, okay, how would that future version of myself show up right now? What would they do? And how can I embody that in this moment? I hope you find this helpful. I personally have found it to be an incredibly powerful exercise. And every once in a while, I sit back down and I recheck in with that ideal version of myself through that same guided meditation that I just led you through. So you might revisit that meditation a month from now and just see if anything has changed. And then again, continue to show up as that person. All right, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy day to watch this. I hope it is of service to you.